Hey everybody, Scott Mitchell here with InMotion Hosting. Welcome to our What is cPanel video. Now cPanel is a program that runs on Linux-based web hosting servers. It's currently the industry standard and it's used by most web hosting companies out there. Now it's designed to make managing your web hosting account much easier by using a graphical interface with lots of different tools in it. So this video we're going to show you a general overview of cPanel and we're going to go over some of the more common tools that are used in a web hosting environment. Okay, so to get to the cPanel, you need to log in, and it's pretty straightforward as far as logging into your cPanel. It's usually tied to your domain name. So if you have a domain name of example.com, the cPanel login URL is usually example.com/cPanel. If you don't have the domain name pointed yet to your web hosting server, then you can use a server name. So if the server name, say for instance, is randomabc.webhostingcompany.com, then you would use randomabc.webhostingcompany.com/cPanel. Okay, and you come up with a login page like this. You would enter your username and password for your hosting account and click the login button. Okay, that takes you right over to the cPanel. This is the main page for the cPanel. Now it's basically divided into two sections. You have the left panel here and the right panel. The right panel has all the different categories and all the different tools represented by icons over here. And the left-hand panel kind of gives you some stats that you can look at on the fly. So if you need to know something, kind of a quick look kind of thing. I'll run down the stats really quickly and then we'll explore the right-hand panel. The stats can be expanded or collapsed. There's a lot of stats here. You can collapse them down to, you know, just a handful by hitting that button there. But we start off with the main domain, which is the domain name that your account is listed under. Okay, your home directory, which shows on the server itself where it would be located. And you can notice here that's going to have this little cPanel username here. That's the username you use to log in. Okay, where you last logged in from, or where the last person to log in was from, their IP address. How much disk space, bandwidth, email accounts, subdomains, park domains, add-on domains, FTP accounts, databases. All this stuff here, how much you've used out of the amount that's allowed on your plan. Now in this case, they either have zero or infinity. This is on a test server, so it's not a typical plan. But say for instance, you have disk space usage, I've used 29 megs out of infinity, so I have unlimited usage. If you're on a plan that has a limit, you can kind of monitor it here. Again, same thing with the bandwidth here. Email accounts, I have one out of infinity, maybe you have account that gives you 100 and you have two and you still have 98 left. It'll show in a progress bar here like you're halfway done. You can see it kind of halfway filled up. Subdomains, park domains, add-on domains. Now subdomains are part of your main domain. So if you have a main domain example.com and you have a blog section and that's kind of separate, you want that under blog.example.com. That's what a subdomain is, and you can have, in this case, unlimited, but maybe you have 25 or 50 or whatever your hosting account allows. Park domains are relatively low in number. If I have example.com and I want example.net to show the same website, I would park it there, like a park domain. And if anybody typed in either one, they would see the same website. That's a park domain. An add-on domain is a completely different website. So if I have example.com and it's about widgets and then I'm going to make a website about, say, puppies, then I would have puppy.com over here, completely different website, completely different everything. That's what add-on domain is. It's added on to the account, but it's not necessarily tied to any of the other domains or any other websites. It can be a completely separate thing. FTP accounts are used to upload and download files, and you can have a certain number of those, and this tells you how many of those you're using. Your cPanel username is automatically created as an FTP account. It's not listed here as one of these. So these would be additional ones. The cPanel user is automatically the master account. So that one can do anything. And the other accounts, you can actually point to specific folders if you want to limit them. SQL databases tells how many you have. Then down here, it says MySQL databases. Some hosting accounts have different types of SQL databases. We have MySQL and PostgreSQL. And in this case, we are only using two MySQL databases. If I had a couple PostgreSQL databases, they may be listed here as well under PostgreSQL databases. How much disk space you're using, what hosting package you're using, if you have the different ones. Your server name, again, this is our test server, so it's right here, but you might have you know, random 123, it would be here, and then you just add the .hostingcompany.com, in our case, .inmotionhosting.com would be the full server name. Your cPanel version, what theme you're using, the Apache, PHP, and MySQL versions that are on your server, okay? The architecture structure, this is a server thing, operating system tells you, but it's again a server thing. Your shared IP address, this is the IP address that is for your cPanel, and if it's a shared IP, probably other cPanels as well. If you do something like buy an SSL security certificate, then in that case, you'll probably have a dedicated IP address, and that IP address will be only for your cPanel. But in the case of shared environments, this is usually shared by several accounts. Path to send mail, so some developers might need to know what that is. Just a quick reference here. Also to Perl, Perl version, and then the kernel version, the cPanel Pro, and service status. If you want to check that out, click and see what that looks like. And it shows you the status of different things running on the server. You can see they are up, the server's running full with full services. Okay, so if you want to have a question about a service on your server, then you can go here and see if it's up and running. So that's the left-hand stats side. That's a quick reference for everything else. Now, the right hand is all your categories. They are not listed in any particular order. This is a kind of a default, but they're not listed in alphabetical or any kind of order. But you can move them. You can grab them here and you can drag them around. So if you decide to make your own configuration, please do so. Okay, we start with preferences here. This is kind of some general stuff. Doesn't really go anywhere else. Some getting started guides and video tutorials. You know, changing your password is pretty important. You need to know what that is. If you want to change your language, say your first language is Spanish or Russian or something like that, you can click here and change the cPanel to that particular language so you don't always have to read the English version. Mail, a lot of tools here for mail. Email accounts is the most used because that's how you create email accounts. Other things here, such as Box Trapper and the Spam Assassin, are used to manage their programs to manage spam and filter out some spam. You can do that a little bit further by using account and user level filtering. So if you have specific email addresses or specific subjects or something you want to limit on your own that's not getting caught by the other stuff, you can also block those here. Other tools here, forwarders and autoresponders. If you're going on vacation, you want to set a response, say, hey, I'm on vacation, I'll be back next week. You do something like that, set that here. So anything having to do with email, okay, even your email DNS, which would be your MX records, are managed here in the mail section, okay? Down here is the files category. You'll spend a lot of time here, particularly in the file manager. We'll go ahead and show you an example of that. If I open the file manager, I have two panels again, left hand and right hand. Left hand's kind of like the main folders and shows where, you know, kind of where I am by highlighting it. And the right hand shows all the details. Inside this public HTML folder are these folders and these files. Here you can upload, download, edit. You know, there's even an HTML editor in here if you want to create a page directly in the file manager here. But this is where you would go to see your files, whether they're images or code or whatever. Again, you can edit and stuff like that here too. So you'll spend a lot of time here, especially if you're developing or moving things around. All right, so backups is another thing with the wizard and the regular backups. So wizards kind of makes it easier, but you can go to backups. It can choose a little bit more customized settings. Very important, so make sure you are backing up your website on a regular basis. Even though the server may do a backup for you, always keep your own. It's like a nice little insurance policy. Over here, FTP accounts. I mentioned those earlier. If you want to create additional FTP accounts, just go over here, click there, and you can create those as needed. Okay, logs, another one that's pretty popular. You can see different types of logs here, how much bandwidth you're using, where the latest visitors come from. The access log, the raw access log, is kind of hard to read, but it's there. If you want to see who's been accessing your account, download that and look at it. Error logs, if you're having problems on your site. And then you have Webalizer and AWS Stats here. And those are kind of error reporting programs, and they report all kinds of things. By your traffic by the day, by the month, by the year even, where it's coming from, which country's sending the most traffic, stuff like that, okay? So let's go on down to security. You have the ability to password protect certain directories to keep people out, okay? You can deny certain IP addresses from accessing your site altogether. If you want to allow a shell access to your account, someone wants to work on it remotely through command line, then you can kind of activate that here, okay? Domains here, we talked about the subdomains, add-on domains, and park domains before. This is where those will be listed individually in their own little lists. Okay. You can also manage the DNS for each one of those and your main domain using a simple or advanced DNS zone editor. Okay. Databases here, we have the MySQL group. MySQL databases gives you a list of the databases that's just on your account. The database wizard here helps you create them. The PHP MyAdmin is a pretty intense tool. It allows you to see every website on every database on your website. It also allows you to manage these by, you can create new ones, you can add columns, and you can add tables, and you can change the data, and you can import, and you can export. So it's a very, very useful tool. And the remote MySQL tool here is used to add IP addresses if you want to use a remote tool to manage from your home computer. You just put your IP address in there so you can see it. Otherwise, it won't let anybody do it. So it's a security tool. Down here for software and services in advance, these are more for the advanced users, except for the Softaculous application installer. This is for everybody. And this is an installer. Okay, there's 280 plus different software listed in this thing. So whether you're putting WordPress in there, or you're putting an e-commerce platform in there, you're uploading a yard sale program, it's pretty much all kinds of different programs in here you can pick from. And this is a quick installer that lets you install it much faster. It creates the database for you, installs the program, so you don't have to do it all manually. So that's probably the most used tool out of here. For the more advanced, you guys have, you know, the different Perl modules, pair packages, stuff like that. PHP configurations, useful if you need to change the version of PHP used for your account. Again, I told you over here, you can see the PHP version for the server, but say if you want to use 5.2 or 5.6, whatever, you can change that for your account here in the configuration tool. And then down here is the advanced stuff. The most used item here is the cron job. And cron job is when you're going to set a script that you've written or purchased or whatever to run at a certain time. So maybe you set a script to do your backups for you automatically every day at midnight. You would set that here. A cron basically means chronological. So if you think of it that way, it's your timing jobs or timing tasks to do something. And then of course you have the different managers for images, index, Apache handlers, and stuff like that for the advanced user. So if you don't know what these are, you probably don't need them. If you do need these, then you know what they are, kind of thing. But this is where you would find all these tools. Again, you can drag things around and make it a little easier to manage. All right, and this is the cPanel. This is the all the different tools and icons in here that you can use to manage your web hosting account. Thanks for joining us for our What is cPanel video. If you enjoyed the video, be sure to like it and subscribe to the YouTube channel below. Also, don't forget to leave any questions or comments you have below so we know what to bring you in future videos. Thanks and see you next time.
Do you know the InMotion Hosting Support Center has thousands of articles, pictures, and video tutorials to help you out with your web hosting questions? Something for everyone, from beginners to experts. Join our community and sign up with your Facebook or Google Plus for free swag, prizes, and discounts. Visit our support center at InMotionHosting.com/support.